Well, first objection is you are a liar, we are secular nationalist, society is casteist, our caste is superior, we have no issues with others, they are also human, they are friendly, they also behave nicely, they are nice neighbors, we can give them some concessions, everyone has their own way of life and we can accommodate them, they are loyals and patriots, etc. Okay, point out to them where the stones are pelted. Rape, loot, exodus happens. They will brush off. In my opinion, at local level, saving physically from stone pelter is a very important task. Take inspirations from Roman infantry seals. Easy peasy. For a moment, let me put aside all your reservation without commenting on it and let's concentrate on what this proposed theory says. What is the root of this theory? We have credible existential threat and a silent challenge. We will be wiped out physically, demographically, democratically, economically, socially, our dharma will be crushed. This will happen to all without our own fault or merits. No one will be spared. Unbelievable. See the public census data. You don't believe it? It's okay. Let's focus on it. What we will be wiped out? Is there really any threat to existence? We have all protective system for all perceivable threats. Where is the source of threat? There is no visible source. Yes, for ages we are afraid to name it properly. It's the life of Muhammad bin Dabagul. What he did in his entire life can be summed up in few words. He taught and practiced rape, loot, kill, occupy and convert. They have a reputation that in 30 years time frame or in 3 generations, by all means, they wipe out the existing original civilization and establish Arabic culture. They do not assimilate and always taking over the multicultural state. They have techniques and methodology to do it. Take their history. They have created havoc on endemic civilization. After ruining them, winning them, they create an Arabic culture there. To wipe out any civilization, what you need? See this checklist. First, will the coming civilization kill the endemic civilization? Answer is yes. But today there is rule of law, they can't, we are numerous, haha. Open your eyes. In Delhi massacre, who got killed most? Who burned Nalanda? Who burned Takshila? Sindh, Somnath? And there is history of burning, raping, looting, annihilating our peoples en masse. Whose economic institution damaged more? Whose houses burned more? Who put stones on streets? Does their leader vouch for it? Yes. Did their originator of religion did this rape, loot, kill? Yes and big yes. Do our compatriots whom we believe are our brothers do believe in the same words and theory of rape, loot, kill, expand? Yes. It is entrenched in their mind more than the democratic value? Yes. Will the education will remove their faith from rape, loot, kill, expand theory and practice? Big no. They will be more empowered and find out more ways to do it. I still do not believe you. Yes, my neighborhood peoples are good. You see, we find good and bad peoples everywhere. They are not practicing rape, loot, kill. Okay. Agreed. But does your good neighbors do believe in that leaders who advise rape, loot, kill? It will be yes. Do they stop them from doing rape, loot, kill practice? No. Once they dominate the area, the rape, loot, kill incidents happen suddenly, without any reason or on any pretext, and your genocide exodus happens. You lose your homes, livelihoods, lives, and whole your society collapse. It will be hard to even survive. Ask the Pandits in Kashmir, Hindus in Sindh, Sikhs in Lahore. Ask Yazidis, women in Iraq. It was just few years back. Will it not come to you? It will surely come. So it is a systematic, gradual, and slow, localized thing that we are not able to grasp it. They have a centralized entity to drive, motivate the people to do rape, loot, kill. Their root of success lies in that an organized, trained, motivated armed group can be dangerous to unorganized, unmotivated, unarmed big groups. Numerical superiority has nothing to do with our survival. They are doing it, did it in the past, do it, hold the area and create their peace, and then expand again. What you can do? First, understand this theory, propagate it. Second thing, our ancestral beliefs, all our traditional institution, groups, that is caste, religion, regionalism, language, history, economies, temples, dharam gurus, etc., are falling apart and not able to deal with them individually and collectively. In all our institutions, we have reached a point of no return. A weakness has crept in. We feel tired. What to do? Where to change? We do not want to change. Pressure is too much. Economy is down. Urbanization is increasing, and with it, the cost of living is increasing. Urbanization is helping them in uprooting our culture, values, peaceful environment, health of people. The able-bodied, educated person not able to get decent jobs in cities. We are not finding cleanliness to do prayers. Water is polluted. Tirtha Kshetra occupied by others. Business rivalries increasing. This is a chaos. The government day-to-day control our individual lives are increasing. What to do? Here is benchmark. First, we can gain our power by giving up and withdrawing a little bit of our loyalties to politicians and making a pressure to them that you need to save us first, make laws beneficial to us, remove the law which is aiding the Kaswai Hind, remove their minority status. Second thing, we dislike your policy of Sabka Saath, Unka Vikas, Biswas and Sahin Begums. This will not work. We dislike your Gandhi, Jinnah, Nehru secularism. We will not vote you both rivals, but we file our independent candidates against both big bigs. Third, we start discussing and making an independent body to cover all aspects of our life, dharma. We create a fund to heal all the victims of exodus, stone pelting, etc. We create a parallel institution which can help us realize our dharma. Fourth, we spill out into the roads to do Ram Lila with bows and arrows, every now and then flesh mob for Hanumanji, instill values into kids, society. We shut down all the politicians and other state machinery to define us what is dharma. We ourselves will define what is dharma. We are more ancient than 70,000 years. How we survive this much? We change our values. We need to survive this malecha storm by resisting it. Let's make a change. Shiv ka sasan hai, Shiv ka sasan hai.